In the second video of the Getting Started series, we are going to learn how to restructure data as it is being translated. The left-hand object represents the source data, or what I have. The right-hand object represents the output data, or what I want to get. We call these objects feature types. The name of the feature type represents the name of the input or output table. By dropping down the arrows, I can also see what attributes are being read and written. As an FME-er, you will often hear the word schema. This is the title we have given for table names and attributes. To get exactly what I want in the output set, I must edit the output schema. Click on the writer to view the feature type properties in the parameter editor window. If I want to rename the output table, I can do so under the Parameters tab by changing the text in the Feature Type Name field. In this case, I'll change Parks to Vancouver Parks. To edit attributes, I click on the User Attributes tab. Here I can see the list of attributes currently being created on the output data set. If I want to remove an attribute, I can do that by clicking it and pressing the minus button or the delete button on my keyboard. I can rename an attribute by clicking a name and editing it. I can change an attribute type by selecting it from the list. Notice that only the data types permitted for the current format are being shown. Finally, I can add a new attribute by entering a name and selecting a data type. I'll add park area and set it to XML_real32. When I click Apply, these changes are reflected on the workspace canvas. Notice that one connection between the source and output attributes is lost because I changed neighborhood name on the source to neighborhood on the output. I can fix this by dragging a new connection from the source neighborhood name yellow output port to the writer neighborhood red input port. This makes the output neighborhood port change from red to green as the attribute is now connected. We call this schema mapping.